your mother was a very influential figure in your life. So in what specific ways do you feel you owe a lot to your mother?
Oh yes, I owe a lot to my mother. Not a kind of book. It's very different difficult to differentiate and say, I just owe it to my mother and not to my father and not to others. But because my father was away working so hard and my mother was with me, she did influence me. And I'm a product of what she has struggled for. And I'm sure a whole lot of our generations and generations to come are products of what the people, and especially the women of that era, struggled for. She was born in 1911, and that was a time when there was no question of girls studying, being sent to school, and especially girls coming from the Dalit families. But my grandfather, who's a
my
maternal grandfather was a doctor in the British Army and got a Victoria Medal. But he later joined the freedom movement, and he was an impassioned advocate for women's education. So he wanted to educate his daughters. He was living in Kanpur. None of the schools in Kanpur gave admission to his daughters because they were untouchables, except a Christian school which admitted them. So that is how they started studying. Then after they passed out, my Nana wanted to study them, send them for higher studies. So he sent my mother to Lucknow in a hostel where again she had to face acute untouchability. She couldn't eat with other girls at the dining table.
Which was the Lucknow College, do you remember?
It was Lucknow Normal School. It was called Lucknow. It was for higher studies and also for teachers' training. Later she became a teacher. She became a teacher in a government school. She used to teach geography. So she couldn't eat at the dining table with the rest of the girls. She was made to eat outside in the portico. And any other person, I think, would have left. But she was so determined. She completed her studies. That's why I consider her to be a great influence on me. She completed her studies. More than that, I want to tell you that because of her behavior, the girls who used to hate her started loving her. But the moral of the story is, please don't judge people by their caste, by their background, by the money they have, or the cars they own. Please don't judge them by how they are inside. And just love them. So, my mother later, at that time, girls going out to study, girls going out to work, they were a complete taboo. They broke that taboo. And that's what I'm saying. I'm a product of that struggle, that great social journey which was taking place in 1930s in India. We are all a product of that, and we are progressing, and we should progress more.
Thank you. That was very inspiring today. We heard that you were a great rifle shooter in your childhood and teenage years, with a lot of tournaments that you won. So tell us more about how that began. And do you still make time for it?
Well, this came as when I was studying in Maharani Gaitri Public School, and we were taught rifle shooting. So I got so interested in it. I used to be doing it all the time, and we were doing it to the satisfaction of our trainer, who was very, very strict. But and then later we were going to I think even in your school and college, they must be going for NCC camps.
That's right.
Yes, so NCC camps I was going to, and we used to have shooting, rifle shooting for clay pigeons and also for target shooting for models cut out into human frames, and used to shoot. I was very fond of that shooting. Just shooting for, human frames, not going beyond that.
Would you, if suppose someone gave you a rifle now, would it all come back to you? Or
no, later when I was in the academy in Matsuri for IFS training, there also I joined the rifle shooting club. And people didn't think I could even hold a rifle, and why did I join it at all? But then I was...
You proved it to them that you